Well, Melbourne is now the seventh most unaffordable city in the world to buy a home, trailing just behind Hong Kong, Sydney, Vancouver and some US cities. Adelaide came in ninth. Demographer Mark McCrindle joins me now. Good to see you, Mark. Why are we so high on this list?
Well, because even though wages have gone up now and are about $100,000 a year average for those full-time earnings, the house prices have been going up faster. Now, Melbourne's had reasonably slower price growth over the last couple of years, but if you put it in ratio form, the average house in Melbourne is more than nine times those average annual earnings. Four decades ago, it was less than three times average annual earnings. So you can just see how far prices have blown out compared to earnings, and that's why it's now in that unaffordability category.
Now, all of Australia's major housing markets have been severely unaffordable since the early 2000s, according to this research. Just how entrenched is this problem?
Well, it just seems to be getting worse. Units aren't as bad in Melbourne. They're about six times average annual earnings. This study says that if it's more than three times the average annual wages, then it's unaffordable, but if it's more than nine times, it's impossible. So at least ownership of a unit is still possible in Melbourne. But, you know, part of the challenge that we're seeing here as these prices for both homes and units rise is that people are looking for other alternatives. People are moving to the regional areas. People are moving interstate because there's still slightly better affordability in places like Adelaide. Even there, you know, prices are fast growing. Australia, because the demand for housing is exceeding the supply that we're creating, is just in that unaffordable category.
The report also says our housing crisis is an existential threat to the middle class. Is that true?
Yeah, well, that's right, because, you know, even if you couldn't afford the top end houses, those in the middle or the lower quartile were still affordable. But even here, right across Melbourne, they are just in that unaffordable category. And as I mentioned, even units are starting to climb up into that. So it does make it hard. And this is on the back of, well, just this week, the population data came out for Victoria showing that it's had record population increase in the last 12 months, 186,000 new residents in the state. Victoria hits the 7 million mark next month in terms of total population, and it's the fastest growing state in Australia. So when you've got record migration, you've got the births as well, and you've got record population increase, it means that demand exceeds supply, and so those prices will go up.
The report was also critical of the way we actually use land, saying it artificially restricts housing supply. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, we do need to keep looking at land release. You know, there's been a big focus on increasing densification and across Melbourne and beyond building more units. But, you know, three in four households in Victoria are still living in detached homes. So it is about providing the homes with the land, not just densifying everything, because that's what people want. And yes, unless we can get the planning right, the zoning right, and probably even a different stock, you know, more of the townhouses and the smaller homes, we're just going to make it harder and harder for that next generation to get a foothold in property. Certainly it's harder now than it's ever been before in our history.
It certainly is. Mark McCrindle, appreciate your time. Thank you.